Members of Apollo Kibuloy's church are set to face charges for obstructing the police in their search for the embattled televangelist at the Kingdom of Jesus Christ compound in Davao City. The Criminal Investigation and Detection Group says the raps include sedition, obstruction of justice, and direct assault. The CIDG adds a disbarment case will also be filed against Israelito Torion, the chief legal counsel of the religious sect. Torion says they are ready to answer the charges.
Siguro ito ang season of tribulation ng Kingdom of Jesus Christ. All of these cases will soon meet its destiny. And what will be their destiny? The trash can. All of these cases are only seasonal. And the season of redemption, the season of vindication will soon arrive.
Meantime, CIDG Director Police Brigadier General Nicolas Torre III says some media practitioners have already filed complaints with the Presidential Task Force on Media for unjust vexation and physical injuries against KOJC members. Dismissed Philippine Mayor Alice Go denies knowing the alleged Chinese spy who spoke in an Al Jazeera documentary. Now, the documentary features alleged former spy Xie Zhizhang, who claims Go asked him to fund her 2022 mayoral campaign. Zhang also showed the news outlet a collection of documents which listed Go as a supposed spy of China's Ministry of State Security. The document listed China as her birthplace and Fujian province as her family address. Al Jazeera discovered that the address was, in fact, the local office of China's Communist Party. Zhang urged Go to tell the truth, but Go denied all the allegations at Friday's hearing of the House Quad Committee.
Go Huaping, kilala mo ba si Xie Zhizhang? Yes or no?
Your Honor, yung Xie Zhizhang na sinasabi niyo po, yan po ba yung pinakita niyo po kanina sa akin sa picture?
Correct.
Hindi ko po siya kilala. At sana po, Your Honor, Mr. Chair, makuha ko rin po yung details. Gusto ko po magdemanda. Never po ako humingi ng campaign fund during my campaign period. Hindi po ako spy, hindi po ako nasa picture, at hindi rin po, Your Honor, ako yung sinasabi niya.
The Philippines' National Security Council assures the public the government has an effective counterintelligence strategy against former or foreign spies in the country. This comes after the Joint House panel cited a documentary of alleged Chinese sleeper agents operating in Philippine soil. Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya, however, says the claims need to be verified since the information came from a wanted criminal and it could be part of a disinformation operation. Meanwhile, the Armed Forces says it has contingency plans in place amid reports of foreign operatives.
Our intelligence operatives are doing their roles in this. We are getting all of the information that we need, and we have contingency plans that are in place, and our units are ready to perform our mandate of securing the nation and our sovereignty.
Former General Manager of the Philippine Charity Sweepstakes Office, Royina Garma, admits appointing relatives to positions in the agency during her term. A member of the House Quad Committee has questioned the appointments, which includes Garma's daughter, noting she was unqualified for the post.
I will tell you the qualification of a confidential agent. One, a bachelor's degree in criminal justice. Two, may experience siya. Previous experience in law enforcement. Meron ba siyang experience sa law enforcement? Your daughter?
None, Mr. Chair.
Correct.
She's very competent in report writing, Mr. Chair, in editing communication.
Garma's defended her decision, saying the positions given to her relatives required only trust and confidence. Meanwhile, the former state lottery chief also admitted creating the STL party list, but denied PCSO funds were used for it. A Chinese businessman thrust into a Philippine congressional probe is cited in contempt by lawmakers. The House Quad Committee late Friday ordered Tony Yang, detained at the Quezon City Jail, for failing to answer questions by one of the panel's members. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, however, requested that he be detained at the PAOC Temporary Detention Facility in Pasay City. Yang denied knowing a certain Ricky Go and Alan Lim were allegedly his partners in a rice milling business in Cagayan de Oro. Yang is also being investigated for his alleged ties to illegal offshore gaming operations. He is believed to be the owner of the Philippine Sanja Steel Corporation in Cagayan de Oro, which allegedly had a similar layout as the illegal pogo hubs in Tarlac and Pampanga. The businessman previously admitted to possessing a fake Philippine birth certificate. He is the brother of Michael Yang, the erstwhile economic advisor of former President Rodrigo Duterte.
There are two personalities, drug personalities, that I mentioned that are included in the incorporator as incorporator of the two companies. And he lied twice. In front of us, he is lying. So I think, Mr. Chairman, it's high time that we have given this guy a chance that we cite him in contempt.
Joint military drills between Manila and its allies in the West Philippine Sea. Naval and air assets of five nations are joining the exercises. More in this report.
The Philippines cites the importance of conducting joint maritime operations with allies in support of the country's defense posture. This comes as the militaries of the Philippines, Australia, Japan, as well as New Zealand and the United States hold joint maritime drills today. AFP spokesperson Francel Margaret Padilla says these activities benefit Filipino soldiers and improve interoperability among the participants.
In our case, we are fortifying our defenses in terms of looking at our interoperability with our alliances. No? This activity is actually conducted in a manner that is consistent with international laws and with due regard to the safety of navigation and the rights and interests of other states. So this will also strengthen our cooperation with this like-minded nations who are joining. And of course, it will upgrade the skill sets of those who are involved.
Padilla hopes more like-minded nations will join the multilateral maritime cooperative activities.
From those who are attending, these are planned in previous months when it will be conducted, and it is open to like-minded nations who wish to join. Mm-hmm. These are series of different multilateral maritime cooperative activities, and each time there can be different countries who are joining. So in this case, it's us, five countries who signified intention to do this and this fourth maritime multilateral cooperative activity. And we're hoping that in our next activities like this, there will be more like-minded nations who will be joining us.
It's the first time New Zealand is taking part in the joint maritime exercises, which are being held within the Philippines' exclusive economic zone. Naval and Air Force units from the five countries are participating to strengthen cooperation in support of a free and open Indo-Pacific. The Philippines has been increasing its training engagements with foreign partners as China continues to aggressively assert its sweeping claims in the South China Sea, ignoring a 2016 ruling that has invalidated its claims in favor of Manila. Meantime, China says it has organized its own maritime drills near waters surrounding Scarborough Shoal also on Saturday. The People's Liberation Army says naval and air force assets conducted routine reconnaissance, early warning, and patrol exercises. In a statement, the PLA said that certain external countries are stirring up trouble in the South China Sea, causing instability in the region. It adds their troops are on high alert and will defend what it claims as its national sovereign security.
Filipino voters urge to be more discerning in choosing candidates for next year's midterm elections. University of the Philippines Professor Jean Franco offered that assessment on Saturday ahead of the filing of certificates of candidacy for the 2025 polls beginning next week. Now, Franco is unconvinced that the Senate slate of the Marcos administration would offer something new to voters. She, however, believes the Makabayan Coalition has candidates that could bring alternative solutions to the nation's pressing problems. Franco admits, though, popularity is still crucial to winning the elections.
Because the Senate is elected nationwide, very crucial that your name is known nationwide. At least you have to have awareness. I actually urge the voters to be discerning, to try new names, because the Senate needs to be diverse. and more representative of the different ways of life of the Filipinos, different socioeconomic classes, different identities.
The Philippine President's sister is stepping away from the administration's Senate lineup for the 2025 midterm elections. Senator Aimee Marcos on Saturday said she would no longer be part of the Alianza para sa Bagong Pilipinas, a coalition formed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. She says she would stand on her own so as not to further put her brother in a tight spot. That decision comes amid the growing rift between President Marcos and Vice President Sara Duterte. Now, the senator has backed Duterte amid impeachment rumors and intense scrutiny by House lawmakers of the Vice President's proposed budget for next year.
Taos puso ang aking pasasalamat kay Pangulo Bongbong na sa kabila ng galit at labis na kalupitan ng ilan, ako'y pinagtanggol niya at naisama pa sa alyansa. Minabuti kong manindigan ng mag-isa upang wag nang malagay sa alanganin ang aking ading, para wag nang mag-alinlangan ang aking mga tunay at minamahal na kaibigan.
The administration ticket says it respects Senator Marcos's decision. Campaign manager Toby Tiangco adds they will continue to support her for the legislative agenda of the president. A third petition is filed at the Philippine Supreme Court to halt the transfer of PhilHealth funds to the National Treasury. The Nagkaisa Labor Coalition Group, led by lawyer Sonny Matula, warned of possible misuse in the handling of the nearly 90 billion pesos in untapped funds by PhilHealth. The group believes the funds should be appropriated for its intended use to improve healthcare services for Filipino workers.
Yung pondo ng PhilHealth ay dapat sa healthcare yan ng mga kababayan nating Filipino. At sa batas po ay yan po ay appropriated na at nakalaan, nakaprograma na para sa healthcare ng mga manggagawang Pilipino at ang pag-damage nito sa unprogram appropriation ng pamahalaan na talaga namin ay isang negatibo. It is a negative social justice na may mawawala ng epekto yung mandato ng konstitusyon na dapat ang mga manggagawa natin ay maprotektahan.
Two similar petitions were previously filed at the High Court against the controversial order of the Finance Department, but the agency has insisted on the legality of that move. The Supreme Court will hear oral arguments on the case on January 14th, but critics say it may be too late, because the final tranche of nearly 40 billion pesos will be turned over to the National Treasury by November this year. Pump price is expected to rise for a second straight week due to escalating tensions in the oil-rich Middle East. Estimates show diesel prices could increase by as much as 90 centavos. Gasoline and kerosene, meanwhile, could see an increase of up to 50 centavos. The Department of Energy has said the increase is due to supply uncertainty amid heightened violence between Israel and Lebanon, as well as fluctuations in the United States' fuel inventory. BYD Philippines rolls out what it called its game-changing electric vehicle as it hopes to encourage more Filipinos to shift to EVs. Jackie Pascual gives us a look at the BYD Seagull.
BYD Philippines has launched its most affordable electric vehicle or EV model, the BYD Seagull, with a price tag of 898,000 pesos. BYD officials hope that with this price point, more Filipinos will consider shifting to electric vehicles, speeding up the adoption of EV usage in the country.
With the price point, the quality of the vehicle, the tech features that includes that's included with the vehicle, plus of course the safety features of the vehicle, is truly a game changer at this price point.
Despite its low price compared to other EV models, the Seagull packs features such as a voice command system, a mobile phone wireless charger, a cruise control feature. The car also has a range of up to 300 kilometers in a single charge, enough for several days depending on usage. and one single charge only costs around 600 pesos, according to BYD Philippines Managing Director Bob Palanca. He adds, drivers can expect low operating and maintenance fees.
With a blade battery that is capable of giving you 300 kilometers in range, go up to Tagaytay round trip 2 times with one single charge.
Palanca also assures the public more charging stations are being built nationwide, including in malls and even residential areas. With the entry of a more affordable EV, BYD expects to capture a new market and grow further. BYD has already significantly grown its presence in the Philippines since Ayala's AC Mobility became its distributor last year.
BYD is proudly the top new energy vehicle brand in the Philippines. BYD has a dominating 80% market share in new energy vehicle sales. Now selling 400, 500 units a month. And to put that in perspective, the total industry EV sales in 2023, the entire year of 2023, is just about that number. The electrification of Philippine mobility has truly begun.
BYD now plans to open one dealership per week starting October until the end of the year. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.